إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. Allah clarifies in His book the reality of this worldly life, the reality that we as mankind are going to be going through trial and tribulation every single day of our life. From the moment we are born until the day we leave this life, we will be going through trials and tribulations and calamities. It's not the whole of the life, but Allah promises in the Quran. He says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ We surely will test you. We surely will try you. We surely will put you through calamities. بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ. With a little bit of fear, anxiety, and hunger, and loss of life, loss of wealth, declining of fruits and vegetables. But Allah says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. But give good news to those patient people. Now, He also says in Surah Al-Anbiya, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَنَبَلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجِعُونَ. Every soul is going to taste death. And in this life, we will try you with good and bad. The test is not only with difficulties, it's also with the goodness, the wealth, the children, the position. Also the goodness of this life, we will also try you with that. This whole life, Allah says in this ayah in Surah Al-Anbiya, the whole life is a trial for you. وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجِعُونَ. But to us, you will be returned. Now, what I mentioned these ayahs for, I want us to think and reflect today. Because we go through these trials and tribulations, and a lot of times we receive them or perceive them in the wrong way. When us as believers, inshallah, may Allah make us of the mu'mineen, we should be taking all of them in a good reception. Because the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرُهُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٍ وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ. I'm amazed, Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm amazed by the affair of the believer. Truly all of his affair is good. وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ. And that is only for the believer. That's for no one else. إِنْ أَصَابَتُ سَرَّى شَكَرٍ. If goodness, if prosperity was to come to him, he will be thankful. When asabatu darra sabr, and if he was to get afflicted with difficulty, adversity, he's patient, and that is better for him. So we want today to mention some of the reasons why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts us through trial and tribulation, and how us as the believer is always good for us, no matter what you're going through. It's always your benefit if you receive it with the correct reception and you receive it with patience and expectation and reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the beginning, first aspect, why do we go through trials and tribulations? Why do we go through calamities? Why do we go through loss of life? Why do we go through loss of wealth? Why do we get sick? Why do we get into accidents? Why do these problems happen to us in this life? Aren't we the believers? Huh? Why is Allah doing this to us? Why? Of the reasons, firstly, is because if Allah did not put us through trial, we will be drowning in disobedience. That's one reason. If Allah did not put us through trial and tribulation, which is a means of waking us up, a means of waking us up, someone may be dealing with haram, selling haram. Maybe he'll be away from Allah, not making the salah, so on and so forth. Yani doing the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is displeased with, that is disobedient. When Allah puts him through that trial and he has that foundation of iman, what does it do to him? What does it do to her? It wakes her up. It wakes him up. Na'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقُهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that corruption, the ulama mean this fasad that became widespread on the earth by what the hands of the people have put forth. He said, this is sickness and loss of wealth. Yani calamities that happen to us, Allah says is by our own hands. Meaning by our own disobedience and our own wickedness that we did in this life. But why? Allah says, لِيُذِيقَهُمْ So He make them taste. So He can make them taste a little bit of what they did. لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا So that He make them taste a little bit of what they did. A little bit of their sins. وَيَعْفُونَ كَثِيرٌ And Allah, He pardons much of what we do. But from His mercy is that we will be doing disobedience. We will be doing wrong. And it hit us on our head a little bit. He gives us a little spark to wake us up and let us reflect. I'm not praying. I'm not dealing with the haram. I'm not treating people right. I'm arrogant. I'm not worshiping Allah as He's supposed to be worshipped. I'm running after the dunya, 100% in the dunya. I forgot my whole akhirah. Allah puts you through a trial. Remember what your purpose is, Ya Abdullah. Remember what your purpose is. لِيُذِيقُهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرِجِعُونَ So He may taste them, let them taste a little bit of what they were doing so they can return back to Him. This is the purpose. Is this not a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It's not a mercy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put you to a trial that allows you to sit your behind down and think a little bit. Because when you run and everything is going good, you don't think about Allah. When everything is going good and everything is being prosperous, you forgot about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Us naturally as human beings, when everything is going good, we forget the akhirah. When things are going bad, Ya Allah, I want your akhirah. Ya Allah, give me tawbah. Ya Allah, I don't want this dunya, Ya Allah. That's when things are going bad. But when things are prosperous, we're running after this dunya. We want it. If Allah left you on that, He will be just luring you to the hellfire. So from His mercy is that He puts you through a trial so you can remember your purpose and you make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you get right back on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لو رأيت الله يؤتي العبد ما يحبه من الدنيا على معاصيه فإنما هو استدراج. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving His servant that which He loves from the dunya, everything is prosperous, everything is going good. If you see Allah giving His servant that which He loves from the dunya, while he is disobedient to Him, while he is in a state of disobedience, the Prophet ﷺ said, know for sure that is only a word called istidraj, which means luring him straight to the hellfire. That's what that is. So don't look at someone who is doing wrong and you see him getting all this from the dunya. That's nothing. Wallahi, tallahi, wa billahi, this dunya is a number of days. When we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we will be asked, how long you have been here? How long have you been here? People will say, I was just here morning. I was just here afternoon. I was just here a day. So the reality of the dunya, you see people going and getting this and getting that, but they're in disobedience to Allah. Surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take care of them and give them exactly what they deserve. Now, so when Allah puts us through a trial, the first aspect I want to mention, He puts us through a trial when we're in disobedience so we can return back to obedience after making tawbah. Now, another reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts us through trial and tribulation, and those who are going through consistent trial, whether you have a sickness, whether you have a problem, yani a physical ailment, whether you have a mental issue, whether you have family issues, your children, your brothers, your mother, your father, yani consistent issue that's going on for a long time, over and over, it's not stopping. It's not just something you got, yani, for a day or two or a week. No, it's consistent. I give you the good news from the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Ma yusibu al-Muslim min nasabin, wala wasabin, wala hammin, wala hazin, wala adhan, wala ghamman, hatta shawkata yushakuha illa kaffara Allah biha khatayahu." Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, authentic hadith. Nothing will befall, nothing will afflict the Muslim from exhaustion to being tired, to being sick, to being worried, to grieving of the past. Any harm that comes to him, any stress, even the pricking of a thorn, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make those things that he's going through a means of expiation of his sins. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi tallahi billahi. If we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sinless, we're going to wish and we're going to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, I thank you for this calamity. I thank you that you put me through that. I thank you that you put my children through that. I thank you that you gave me that sickness. Because when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your scale of good deeds outweighs your bad deeds, because you come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sinless from that difficulty that you went through, either with yourself, your wealth, your family, you will thank Allah for it. Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا يَزَالَ الْبَلَاءُ مَا زَالَ الْبَلَاءُ بِالْمُؤْمِنِ وَالْمُؤْمِنَ فِي نَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ وَوَلِدِهِ حَتَّى يَلْقَ اللَّهِ وَمَا عَلَيْهِ خَطِيئًا. Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the calamity, the trial, the tribulation will be upon the believer, believing man and the believing woman, within his own self. You got problems within your own self that nobody knows about. You got issues in your head. No one in this whole dunya knows it. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You got issues within your own self that nobody knows about. But that issue that you're being patient with, Allah is expiating your sins from it. Wealth. He said the trial will be within his self, within his wealth, and within his children. All the time with the believer and the believing. All the time you were going through stress and trial and tribulation with these things. With your wealth. How much of us as men and even women today are their biggest stress on a daily basis is money. Some people had a lot of money. They have nothing. Some people are making ends meet every month just trying to pay the bills, working hard. Huh? This is a trial that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be expiating your sins for that. And you're going to thank Allah yawm al-qiyamah for the trial that he's went through. With your children. The most beloved thing to you in this whole dunya, your children, your son, your daughter, that's your heart right there. You see them, your heart melts. It hurts you so much to see them go through things. It hurts you so much to see them maybe not doing well in certain things. This trial that you're going through with your heart, your beloved children, this is a means of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expiating your sins. Now, so that's number two. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the trials and tribulations that we are going through, remember this and never forget it. Even if it's a trial that's continuous, going on for years, know that this is a means of Allah expiating your sins for you to meet Him yawm al-qiyamah and be sinless and enter straight into Jannah. Number three, before I finish the first khutbah, why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us through trial? He puts us through trial to let us know who is the real believers from the fake. Who is the real believers from the fake believers? Who's the ones who are truthful in their statement of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he cleans the ranks of the believers with trials and tribulations. Now, وَلِيُمَحِّصَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَمْحَقُ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah says in Surah Ali Imran, and we will purify the believers. We will purify the believers, we will purify them of their sins, and we will purify their ranks from the hypocrites and those who are fake in their statement of La ilaha illallah. We will purify them with these difficulties and these calamities. We will purify them, وَيَمْحَقُ الْكَافِرِينَ, and we will destroy the disbelievers with those same calamities. So the disbeliever, when they go through these difficulties, they're getting destroyed. But the believers, when they go through these difficulties, they're getting cleansed. Allah is cleansing us. When we go through difficulties, I remember trials here in this country, here. I don't want to mention them because that's not the topic. But you see, when there was big occasions, I actually remember when I was 7 years old, 9/11. That was of the greatest trials, and the brothers and the sisters who were here at that time, that was of the greatest trials for Western Muslims. How many brothers and sisters, you remember that time, cut their beard, took their hijab off. May Allah bless them. We're not here to blame anybody. But I'm saying, when that trial came, what happened? There was people who did not want to call, don't call me Muhammad anymore, call me Mo. Right? Don't give me the salam anymore. That was the trial. What happened? Some people skid off. And the brothers and sisters you see here today, they're still here remaining. When the trial happens, Allah, cleans the ranks of the believers. Allah says, Alif la mim, ahasib an-nasu. أي يتركوا أي يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم فلا يعلمن الله الذين صدقوا ولا يعلمن الكاذبين. Allah says, do these people, do you think, do you expect, Do you perceive that you should be left alone because you says, I believe? Allah says that. Do you perceive or do you think because you said, I believe, we should leave you alone? We shouldn't put you through trial and tribulation? Do you think that? Because that's what comes to our head sometimes. Why are we the believers and why are we going through these trials? Why is Allah doing this? Why are our countries in this condition? Why? Allah says, do you think because you say you believe, that means you're supposed to be left alone? وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبَلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. We have surely tried and put to trial and tribulation those who have came before them. Why? So we will know, and Allah knows everything, so we will know who the truthful, who are truthful, who were truthful in their statement of La ilaha illallah, and who was the liars. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. First khutbah, we spoke about the reality of trials and tribulations in this dunya, in this worldly life, and how it's filled with trial and tribulations. And Allah promises us that we are going to go through these trials and tribulations the whole time we live in this worldly life. It's never going to go away. There's no paradise here on earth. People looking for paradise on earth, it's not here. No matter what you get, no matter what you achieve, you're going to have some calamity. You're going to have some trial. So the best thing for us to do is just get used to it. Just get used to it. And just be ready for it to come. And just get stronger and stronger with thabat, being firm and being patient and expecting the reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, another aspect of why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put you, O Abdullah, the one who is praying, he's worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's making siyam, he's giving his zakat, he's giving a da'wah, he's commanding with the good, he's forbidding the evil, he's doing what Allah loves. Why is Allah putting you through a trial? I'm going to give you another reason. Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, authentic hadith on Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said, إِنَّ الرَّجُلْ لَتَكُونَ لَهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْمَنْزِلَةِ فَمَا يَبْلُغُهُ بِعَمَلٍ فَمَا يَزَالُ اللَّهِ يَبْتَلِيهِ بِمَا يَقْرَهُ حَتَّى يَلْقَ اللَّهِ حَتَّى يُبَلِّغُهُ إِيَّهَا. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned maybe the greatest reason why you as being a good believer will be going through a difficulty, going through trial and tribulation consistently. Why? What is the reason? Maybe we don't have the hikmah. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Allah, he wants for you a position in Jannah. Allah wants for you a position in the Jannah. He wants for you not just any position. He wants for you a high position in the Jannah. Al-manzila. He wants you to be up there, folk. He wants you to be up there high in the Jannah. And we know the Jannah is darajat, it's degrees, it's levels. He wants you to be up there high. Lakin, but your deeds are not enough to get you to this position. Prophet ﷺ said, Lakin, لا يبلغه عملا. But his deeds, they're not enough to get him to this position. Not enough to get him to this high place. And Allah is just. He gives you exactly what you put in. He's going to give you what you deserve. If it's good, good. If it's bad, bad. But your deeds will not get you to this place Allah wants you. So the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَمَا يَزَالُ اللَّهِ يَبْتَلِيهِ بِمَا يَقْرَهُ. For Allah will continue to try him and test him with that which he dislikes. حَتَّى يُبَلِّغُهُ إِيَّهَا. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through that trial and tribulation, will make him reach this high level of Jannah. Allahu Akbar. This is how we have to perceive these trials and tribulations, brothers and sisters. You have to perceive it in a good way as a believer. Perceive it with patience. Perceive it with expectation and reward. And really, when we get to a high level, you thank Allah. Wallahi, you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With that trial you're going through, thank Him. When you go into sujood, thank Allah azza wa jal for what you are going through. Wallahi, everyone in here and everyone in this dunya is going through something. You see the brothers coming through the door on a daily basis. You see him smiling. You don't know what he's going through. Everyone is going through something, brothers and sisters. No one is left alone. Everyone is going through something. And if we were to hang our issues on a rack and we were able to see everyone's issues, we will go back and take our own issues. We want to know nobody else's. You want to know no one else's. Naam. So you expect and you receive these issues and these trials with sabr. Ya Allah, give me patience, Ya Rab. Ya Allah, give me patience, Ya Rab. Ya Allah, give me patience, Ya Rab. Ya Allah, give me your Jannah. Ya Allah, give me your reward, Ya Rab al-Alameen. Give me your reward. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, Allah is cleansing you. Allah is cleaning you. Allah is raising you. Allah is elevating you. Allah is making you strong. He's giving you thabat. He's making you hate this dunya and love his akhirah. Is that not a gift? He's making you hate this dunya and love what he has in the akhirah. To love him and to yearn for his paradise. Now, and lastly, I want to finish with who are we to complain, really? When the best of us went through the most severe of trials, who are we to complain? What have we went through in comparison to the prophets and the messengers? Those who are the most closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who received the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Inna shadda nasi bala'an al-anbiya." Truly the most severely tested people are the prophets and messengers. Look at our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him come into this world as a yatim. Before he even entered this world, his father is dead. When he turns 6 years old, his mother is dead. When he turns 8 years old, his grandfather who took him is dead. He becomes a prophet. He's lied. They said he's a liar. They said he's a majnoon. His people lied to him. His people threw garbage on the back of his neck while he's making salah at the Kaaba. They cursed him. They tried to harm him. They hit his tooth out until he's bleeding. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his wife Khadija radiallahu anha, in 1 year, when his whole people boycott him and his companions, his wife Khadija, his first wife, she dies. His uncle Abu Talib, who protected him for all these years, he dies as well. All this trial and tribulation, he's poisoned, and that poison remains with him until that was the cause of his death. He said, "I felt that same pain of the poison while he's on his deathbed." Abdullah ibn Mas'ud comes to him and sees him in his deathbed, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he sees him shaking, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's shaking with such a severe fever. And he says, Ya Rasulullah, innaka tu'aku wa'kin shadidin. Ya Rasulullah, you are going through such a severe fever. You are shaking so severely, Ya Rasulullah. He said, ajal, inni u'aku kama yu'aku rajulani minkum. Rather, I have the fever and I'm shaking like two men will have a fever from amongst you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of mankind. And these are only some of the trials that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for him to go through. And he's the best of mankind to walk the earth. And he is the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what about us? What about us? Take these trials, tribulations with patience. Ask Allah to give you patience. وَمَا صَبُرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. You have no patience except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask him for patience over and over again. Wallahi, over a period of time, that thing was so difficult for you, felt like you couldn't handle it, it becomes easy. It becomes nothing after a period of time. But we have to be patient in the beginning. إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ صَدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. Truly the true patience is in the first striking of the calamity. And remember these things that were stated today. The Jannah, Allah is raising your degree in Jannah. The Ajr, the reward. Allah is testing you and trying to see if you're a true believer and you stay impatient upon that. Wallahi, the day of judgment, the man who had this whole dunya, but he was a kafir, and he will be from the people of the hellfire. Allah will dip him in the hellfire. And it will be asked, this man who had the best dunya possible anyone can have, it will be asked, did you see any goodness in your life? Did you feel any bliss in your life? Did you feel any happiness? He will say, Wallahi ya Rab. He will say, I swear by Allah, my Lord, I never felt any goodness. I never seen any happiness or bliss. But the man who was a believer, who lived the most difficult and most hard life that anyone can live. The Day of Judgment, Allah will just dip him in the Jannah. He will just dip him one time in the Jannah. And it will be asked, did you face any difficulty in your life? Has any hardship came to you in your life? And he will say, Wallahi Ya Rab. He will swear by Allah, I have not seen any difficulty in my life. I have not went through any hardship. This is the reality. Keep your eyes on the prize. Don't let this dunya wear you down. Don't let it wear you down. Keep your eyes on the Jannah. Keep your eyes on the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stay strong. Stay firm on your deen. Get stronger. Don't get weaker. The shaitan wants you to get weak. The shaitan wants you sad so he can weaken you. That's his tool, sadness. Don't let him get you sad. Be happy. Get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go near him. May Allah make it easy on all of us. اللهم آمين